What's going on, dudes? It is Kolosalus here. Welcome back to Heroes of the Storm. Today, we'll be taking a look at Gazlowe, one of the really underpowered heroes in today's meta. Him and Tychus are supposed to be two characters that are going to be buffed and just rebalanced, you know, just looked at basically in the next patch, which is Greymane. That comes out in like 5 days. We're going to be taking a look at Greymane. That should be exciting. Even though his playstyle doesn't really convey to me, but just the same as this character, the playstyle doesn't really convey me. It's all about setting up a certain area and then baiting your enemies right now. I think right now that's the only way to get, you know, some decent kills with Gazlowe. You know, to set up an area with a lot of turrets, you know, go for the turret build, set up an area with turrets, get a team fight into that area, and then grab a bomb, you know, and basically slow down enemies as much as you possibly can, so they take as much damage from your turrets and everything around them. It's a weird playstyle. One really good thing is that while you can also set up area, you can also be a nice sieger. But one really bad thing that I don't like about Gazlowe is his low health total. For a melee character, for a melee specialist, he has a very, very low health total. And especially with the current rotation, I think we have Nova on rotation. He can be caught out quite easily. And hopefully I can show you what I mean with Gazlowe, but we can also get a good game and we can win.
Anyone order a one-man wrecking crew?
Alright, boys and girls, we find ourselves on a two fighter team. Let's say hi to the friends. And let's pick up Scrap-O-Matic Smelter on level 1.
I'm going.
Very, very long queue resulted in this, I don't know, freaking abomination of a team. We have a Lunara, Gazlowe, Rainer, Abathur, and Nova against Sagara, Lunara, Sylvanas, Nova, and Rainer. I will be able to I like this map for Gazlowe because I will be able to claim a lane for myself, and I'll show you guys what I mean exactly. Gazlowe's trait is very, very unexciting. What it will do, basically, your turrets when they are destroyed, or you destroy them yourself when you activate this Dia around them. Activate this D! What will happen is basically they will drop a scrap of metal. I was like, I will be going against Lunara.
I'm going!
Nope. They will drop this scrap of metal. This is freaking Lunara. And what it will do, it will reduce your cooldowns by so many seconds, I'm not sure. 3 seconds. And then I also picked up a talent which is going to get my mana regeneration. Also, like when I pick them up to be like, I don't know, like 60 or something, I'm gonna be able to get like 60 mana back when I picked it, like this little thing right here. Eradicate. This is down here. Try to claim this area for myself. So my Q ability is basically, I put this down, and then I should destroy this before it can get destroyed, and then don't get anything. Really? I don't care. I don't care about your shit, Nova! Yeah, so our cure ability is basically putting down this turret. What it will do, it will basically deal damage in this area to a single target. Afterwards, I think we're gonna pick up a talent, which is going to basically give us. Wait a second, I need to place methodically now. I think Nova is just coming together, so he's gonna go back away to Hearthstone to get some health back. Because we have 40 seconds up until a Kool-Aid. Yes, we'll be able to put down this turret with our Q ability. It will last for like 30 seconds, so you know, it's quite nice, and it will deal some damage. Plus, it will soak shots and also stop minions. Minions will prioritize that shit. I am going to put down the turret right here and do our E ability. Our E ability, I'm not gonna go in order here. Our E ability is this bomb right here. I put it down there. And what it will do, it will basically, after I think like 4 seconds or something, it will explode, deal quite massive damage, and also stun enemies. It will also stun enemies, which is quite cool. There's Nova.
Yeah, baby.
I'm gonna pick this up before she can destroy it. This level range, we are gonna go for Clockwork Steamfist. So I'm gonna explain all that later on. Looks like Rainier did make his way down to the bottom lane. I'm gonna just, as I said, claim this area to myself. You know, put down this connection, get this guy back. Put this bomb right there. What does he want? Gonna destroy this vision. Put this behind me, so this does some damage. I'm gonna put this bomb down. And then we have our W ability, which I won't be using that much. It's a laser, basically. You can see it goes from this like little thing inside to this huge, huge beam that's there. Another one. So you can see I'm gonna use it there. I'm gonna charge it up and deal some damage. I'm gonna put down the stun. It's not gonna get anybody, but of course it's gonna basically zone out an area for me, which is exactly what I want. This Rainer comes in here, not sure why. They should not be interrupting me while I'm laning here. So basically, the more you charge your laser, the more damage it will do. Plus, it will also try to sort this damage for this Rainer. Plus, it will also it will also shoot farther. And be like and have like wider range as well, which is quite nice. I think I'll fix this up right after we get destroyed. Send everyone, by the way. Gonna put down the stun, so if they want to chase Rainer, they're gonna have to go through that stun. And Lunara walks right into it, which is never a good thing to do. I'm trying to drop that Q, and I will get out of there. This will be all fine. Right, I'm not able to speak too much because I'm not sure how to play Gazlowe myself. Because I've only played him for like 5, 6, or 7 games maximum. And, I still haven't gotten used to him, but I already know what like is the best build for him. On this level range, we are going to go for Rocket Turret XL. This is going to allow the turrets to attack multiple targets instead of just one target. So, I'll be able to put it down. And it will be able to attack two targets instead of one. And looks like Nova was able to interrupt him, I think. Yes, she was. I will get in here. Put this down here, so if Lunara wants to turn in, she's going to be interrupted by our... And by our targets. I'm gonna pick up the scrap metal and move up and try to take this Rainer out of this lane. I'm gonna try to destroy this wave with his bomb. Okay, I'm gonna charge up my laser. Deal my damage. Put down this guy. And also just use all of my bombs. Also use it on the structure so we'll also deal damage to the structure. Start dealing some massive damage to the structures as well. Put down this, so if they want to gank me, they're gonna have to go... I'll be able to go up here and they will have to take that damage. Put the bomb on the structure there. I'm gonna start really walking down. This tower's down. I think the enemy we are going to be first is kind of not interesting at all. Put down this bomb. Put down the turret. And so let's just talk about talents. Our talents are on level 1, we picked up so we will also restore mana when we pick up our scrap metal. On level 4 we picked up an ability which will allow our basic attacks to also restore extend the duration of the your turrets, so they'll be able to stay up longer. So basically, if I punch something in the face, I will basically extend the duration of my of my turrets. On level 7, we pick up, so they will attack. They'll basically attack more targets. The turrets will attack more targets. I think up to 3 targets, but the two minor ones will. We're gonna go for grab a bomb on level 10. The two minor targets, not the main target, are gonna take only 50% of damage. On level 10, it looks like she was chasing me. I was right there. Right. then looks like on level 10 we picked up the grab bomb. What it will do in this circle, like this little like smaller circle I just showed you guys right there, what it will do, it will basically grab people inside of that circle, pull them in into the center and deal some damage. There's an obvious combo right there with your E, so you put your E in the middle. Let's try to go. So you put your E in the middle and then you put the grab bomb over it, and of course that pulls everybody into the range of your bomb, and it will explode right in their face. Which is kind of what she said, but they are there, and Lunara's been just gonna get out of that gravel bomb. I thought I'll be able to get her. Obviously, my placing there wasn't perfect, so that's one thing. I'm actually going to take down this floor right there. Put down the bomb. Okay, now we have to get out of here. Now we have to get out of here. Now I'm dead, actually. Yep! Yeah, boys, pick up this fucking. Pick them up. There we go. Yeah, so me and Rainer were a little bit too greedy. I stayed a little bit too long. Looks like I did trade one for one with Lunara. She did walk into the range of my turrets. She was taking some damage from that, but of course she was also taken out by a friendly Rainer and Nova. Right, I'm gonna make my way to the bottom. It looks like it's all abundant, and what Gazlowe should be trying to do, what we're striving to do, is to soak as much XP as possible, and also, you know, be a sieging force. That's what we're gonna try to be doing. I'm gonna put down the bomb straight away. I'm gonna put down this turret right here so it starts doing damage to the enemy troops. Now I can just punch this shit down. Looks like the friendly avatar did go for speed for attack speed on level 4, I think. Interesting with this team composition. Two of our friendlies do go down, which is kind of bad. I did miss that. I'm gonna put down the turret. She was behind me, so she stops chasing me, and there we go. So I'm gonna try to claim this floor myself. Sylvanas is here, so I will try to just be cautious about what I'm doing. Again, trying to defend this myself. Put down the bomb. Looks like my grappa bomb is ready for me right now. There we go. So if I do catch Sylvanas, I will be able to kick her out. There we go! No! Bitch! Terminate this hero. On this upper range, we are going to go for turret storage. I used to go for sprint sometimes, but now I do like to go for extra charge on our turrets. It just allows me to spam them more. Also, you know, it allows you to get more damage out on the board. Not board, but the battleground. Put this down straight away, but so if the enemy Nova doesn't engage, we will be able to deal some damage to our turret before we die. I'm gonna get that. Put this down straight away. Nah, be good. Nah, good. God damn, she almost killed me right there. Nova is nowhere. Yeah, the enemy Nova is in the top lane, so I'm just gonna quickly be out to the Hearthstone to get some health back. We have to launch some grav bombs. Looks like the enemy team. What the fuck is this guy doing? Does he not even know how to play Abathur? I don't think he does. But his locust, like, get to the half of health. No, just like one quarter of health, just when they get to the. There he is. There he is. There he goes now. Okay, so that's the right thing to do. I'm gonna try to help out Lunara. Looks like she's in a little bit of a pickle. Hi, Lunara. Shit. Now I need to be careful. And now, the triple tap coming out is gonna secure a kill on our Jimmy. I'm gonna put this down behind Rainer there. Now I'm gonna be taken out by the enemy Nova. That's the real Nova right there. And our friend Nova is not capitalizing on that. Very nice leech is gonna, I think, secure the living of our. No, Lunara is gonna be taken out, but I think enemy Rainer is also gonna be taken out. There we go. So that was a favorable trade. Actually, no, we traded three for three, so not a favorable trade at all for us. It was, you know, it was just equal, and that's what I meant. This Abathur should be dealing with this push because it's a little bit hard. That's what she said. Let's see. Nope. Right, so we need to start teamfighting, definitely. This build is more teamfight oriented to have the grapple bomb, you know, if the enemies will clump together. It's kind of hard that they're all like kind of backline characters, like, you know, Lunara, Rainer, Nova, you know, they won't be clumping up. Where is the Nova? That's not the real one, that's only the... I'm gonna pick this up for a... Oh, Gazlowe! Right, so if Zagara is trying to invade up here. There's a Gravel Bomb! Our Gravel Bomb is gonna pull in the... Actually, only the copy of Nova, so that was pretty bad. Yeah, I'm not really that good at placing. I'm gonna go for extended range on our Q, on our, you know, on our turrets. They're gonna be able to do some more damage. Rainer is coming in. I'm gonna pick this helpful though. Triple tap coming from the enemy Nova. I'm just gonna let this force soak all the damage for me, and I'll be able to live. The best ultimate in the game. This guy needs to be careful because Nova is in the area. I'm gonna put another turret. Looks like they are just committed to just destroying my turrets. I'm gonna pick every single helpful so I can get the most. I'm gonna try to charge this to find this. Oh shit! No! 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 Fuck you, Nova! Actuated. Oh shit, that was close. Thank you, Robby. Actually, Abathur saved me. Abathur was really helpful there. I'm gonna put down some more fucking... what's the name of that? I'm gonna actually get that to get some mana back. What you doing, Rainer? Trying to creep up on me? Put this down here. This is gonna start dealing damage to you, Rainer. I'm gonna put another one. I'm gonna put this in the middle. So it deals with the minion. Good. We can pick this health orb up and just move up. Start making our way up this lane. Destroy this one, get the mana and cooldowns back on. Yep! The enemy team has a really ganky playstyle. They have Zigzag, who can come in, you know, who has a vision of the end. Not good. Actually, you can get quite nice damage here. Oh my god, very nice! This Abathur definitely knows what he's doing with Nova. But this Nova did not engage. Like, both of them could have taken like two characters out there. She uses her snipe just to deal some really, really bad damage. I wonder what did she go for? At least she went for Amber Snipe. Nova just rolls down there because she is really bad. Our Lunara going really, really far into the enemy team is going to be taken out, but she's going to take... the enemy Nova with her. Now Rainer's gonna take Lunara, but she's gonna take out Rainer. What the hell is going on? Like, what is this game, boys? What is this game? This is not a game for Gazlowe. The fuck? Nice. So we're making our way to the middle lane. Now this Zigzag is fighting. Give them the clamps. Fuck you! Okay, she's gonna be able to get away. I'm gonna make my way here. With this minion fish. Of course, I would have been able to siege a little bit more with a robber goblin, but the robber goblin gives you like a passive, like, what is the actual thing, number? I think like 150% more damage to like enemy minions and like structures, which is quite good. I'm gonna put down another guy right here. If this ranger is not careful, he's gonna die. I should be careful. I'm gonna put this behind me. So if they do try to chase, they will be taking some damage, but they will be stunned. Oh, very nice, very nice. Actually, a very, very easy kill for a friendly team. I'm gonna put down some of my turrets here, and now I am taking damage from the enemy Nova. If she decides to go for a triple tap on me, that's my secure kill, but looks like no. She was just able to get out of the range of our friendly team. On level 20, we are gonna go for the extension. Oh shit, I'm just really very low. I need to go, boys. Actually, I'm gonna put this down first. Yeah, so on level 20, we are gonna go for the extension of our gravel bomb. It will be able to grab enemies, you know, further away. It's basically going to extend the range of the actual ability, which is pulling people in towards the middle. Very, very useful ability. I think the best on the level 24 Gazlowe. Hardened shield's not that bad. Of course, Mecha Lord is good if you did pick up that.
That's what this baby is built for.
Wait, are they turning in or something?
This thing
I don't know.
Is heavy.
I'm trying to soak this damage. I am able to soak the damage. I was nice, very nice. I thought he's gonna move into it to get a kill on me, but he didn't. I think I'm gonna go for miniature black hole. I'm gonna have to go to Barstone again. Like, this is a main problem with Gazlowe. Like, you can't do shit. Like, what happens is, like, you are, like, you know, you go far into a lane, and for example, you get really low, and you have to harvest to the Hearthstone because, like, you don't, like, it's not worth picking up, like, Regeneration Master on level 1. Sometimes it is, but not, it's more worthy to pick up the mana regeneration than it is to pick up the Regen Master, if you know what I mean. I'm gonna put down this bomb. The nice build and then minions right there. And I'm gonna just charge up a laser because I think she's gonna move into the range of that. Rainer's trying to gank from the top. A good idea. I'm gonna try to make my way right here. And looks like we're doing some nice damage with our with the turrets. There we go. Very nice kill from our Abathur is gonna secure. Very nice shot. He's gonna secure a kill on the enemy Lunara. Put down the bomb. Put down one more turret. Claim this for ourselves. Oh shit, okay, now I'm dead. Now I'm just dead, boys! And you can't do anything on the Gazlowe, you know, it's that. It's just that. You basically, when you get caught out in auto position like that, very nice double Nova composition is gonna secure a kill on the enemy Zagara and enemy Sylvanas. Looks like our friend Lunar is gonna be taken out by Nova. That's the real Nova right there, actually. But yeah, our Nova does the right thing. Please turn in. Oh god, the damage! Holy shit! Okay, the Abathur actually knows what he's doing, you know, when actually playing with Nova. I guess that's one good thing. Yeah, so that's what I say. Gazlowe has nothing to do, really. Like, he's a laner, but then he also teamfights a little, but he doesn't have any way of regenerating health. So when you play him, you definitely need the support. And in quick match, that's not the case most of the time. Like, people don't like playing supports for some apparent reason. Like, I love playing supports, like, when I play in quick match.
Destroy this wretched fort.
That Lunara just got away, holy shit. That was pretty bad. Now, if the enemy team is not careful here, I can definitely grab them. And... hi! Oh, she has Blink. She picked up Blink, and I'm dead. Nova, our friendly Nova moved away. I'm gonna put this behind me to try to get some damage. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. I'm gonna move into this tower range right here, so the towers will kill this Hydralisk for me, and I will be able to make it out there. But you can see how, you know, you take a little bit of damage and you're just dead straight away. Like, you're so squishy. Oh no! Oh, I need to secure this kill. I'm gonna put down this turret right here, so it starts doing damage to the enemy Lunara. I'm trying to move in, and I am able to secure a kill with those turrets on the enemy Lunara. But yeah, you have no way of regenerating health other than your regeneration master level 1, and you know, you have some better talents when it comes to level 1 choices, you know what I mean? If you place your turret nicely, they will be able to do some damage to the enemy structures like so. I'm gonna charge up this laser. Put down another one. One really bad thing I think I'm doing right here is actually. And again, you can see how I'm just getting chased off by this freaking Hydralisk. One really good thing is that you can put down your Q ability without actually wasting any time on, you know, stopping, putting it down, and then actually starting to go to move again. You can just put it down. This zigzag is going to be taken out straight away by two of our Novas. What I mean by that is we have our Nova, which is probably our Nova from the friendly Abathur. Put down another turret so it soaks the damage from the tower and we'll be able to take this no problem. Put down another bomb right there to start dealing damage. Take some scrap from the from that. I am. Let's see. I will be there in a moment. Oh yeah, I won't be able to anything. If he tried to trade with Nova there, I could have went for the grapple bomb and just secure a kill on him, but that wasn't the case. Looks like our friendly team does die. Abathur, the slug dies somewhere. Holy shit. So it looks like, I don't know, Rainer was trying to do the camp? What was he trying to do? I don't know what you're saying. I'm going to try to turn in right here. Let my team know. Put down this guy first. So it does deal damage. Oh god. Okay. That's the real one right there. What are you doing? And you can see, I just claimed this spot for myself. We have three of these motherfucking. Right, this was bad.
Well, that could have been worse.
Oh, the blink is gonna save the enemy zigzag here, and I think I will be taken down by this hydralisk. You can see how much damage it's just dealing to me. No, I think we'll be able to get away. Yes, okay, we are able to get away. I'm just gonna go in here and hearth. Like, this amount of health is not worth drinking from the city. So, as Gazlowe, you're actually you're hurting actually a lot when you take damage. Like, especially when your whales are down, like your first tier whales are down, then you're hurting because you can't go to Sippy constantly. And it's just annoying. I'm gonna take down this. Yes, Jewish. It's very strong. Enemy web weavers are defending first. I try to turn in and actually come in here to get some of these coins. Not coins, but what is it, like diamond or something? Gem? I think that's what they're called. Gem. I'm trying to deal with this group. Really, again, playing this area for myself with this turret. Put down this bomb. Another right here and just start charging up the laser to deal all the damage that I possibly can. And you can see how quickly we're able to deal with this, this push. Very, very effective. He's just down with me, take the mana away with me. I'm making my way to help my team right here. Friendly Nova might be able to pick up a kill now. She looks like she just bails on that kill. Actually, yeah, in the middle lane. Yes. Get out of the way of that. Put down another bomb. Another bomb. To deal with this miniature. And we should be able to clean this out, no problem. Okay, so good. Slug dies again. So, potentially, you know, one of our highest damage dealers because he was getting into that Nova ultimate evolution. Or whatever it's called. Able to put my ultimate right there, and we might be able to pick up a kill on the enemy Lunara, and yes, we are. Looks like that poison from the enemy, from the friendly Lunara, did secure that kill. I did deal some damage with my ultimate and my bomb. So overall, a very bad trade, 2 for 4. Actually, no, Slug died before, so warning ping doesn't mean. Oh, let's go there. Yeah, Abathur, you were dead. Don't say anything. Okay, shh. People like when chasing Nova are sometimes like really super greedy. Super greedy. So what is the plan right now? The plan right now is to get into position. To get into position and to secure a very nice gravel bomb. I think that's the way to go. And then we can pick up a very nice multi-kill on the enemy team. And then we can go from there. So if we group up and I get a good gravel bomb, we can do some nasty, nasty shit.
Come
By the way, I hope you guys took a little time to take to look at the color coordination I did with the goblin. That's pretty sick. I enjoyed that. Right, so I think that what I'm doing right now, I should be doing more of just punching things to death, because of course by doing that I will be able to extend, you know, the way over. The enemy team gets caught out in the top lane, so I have my grapple bomb ready. So if I can get in here, I can punch him down like I just doing a triple tap. I'm gonna get actually killed. I'm dead. I'm dead as fuck, boys. My team just doesn't help me. So we were able to pick up the kill of the enemy Zigzag and Lunara. So we are up ahead. It's 3v2 at the moment. Nova. Oh yeah, she did go for the extended triple tap, right? What the fuck? Why wouldn't you pick up the extended triple tap on that shit? Like, she would have been able to, like, secure so many kills on this team. Look at this. I have Zigzag, Lunara, Sylvanas, Nova, and Rainier. Like, all of them are squishies. What is going on right now? We are doing some massive siege damage, by the way. We're doing 252,000. The highest, by far the highest out of the whole game. Not sure. I think my positioning is also a little off. Don't you guys think? Sorry, I have to take a look at my Skype there. So I also think that my positioning is a little off. They're gonna get a nice pay in here. A precision strike would have secured an interrupt there. Very nice leap is gonna secure the escape. By the way, I have my grab bomb ready, so if they do push out too far into our friendly ground, we will be able to deal a lot of damage. I'm gonna push far into this enemy team. If they want to come in here for me, I will. Of course, I think two of them did pick up Blink. I'm gonna take out this vision. Fuck your vision. Fuck you, boy! So Zigzag and Sylvanas, I think, picked up both of the score. Not fun, okay. I think Rainier didn't pick up. I think he picked up like next to his friends or something. I'm gonna shoot behind me. This up. Get my cooldowns. Put this behind me so if the enemy team walks over, they're gonna take some guaranteed damage. Sure, we can do those.
I can handle that.
By the way, they have vision of this. They will have vision of us doing it. It looks like they are just up in the top lane defending against nothing, against like a normal minion wave, so that's bad. We do not have enough for the turn in, sure. Nova is in here. I'm gonna think for danger that she's in this area. I saw her glimmer. So I'm gonna try to come into the ship. So that silence just completely countered my ultimate right there, and I wasn't able to pick anything up with that. We are able to pick up a kill on two members of the enemy team though, and I might be actually dead here. Put this behind me.
Sufficient.
This thing is heavy.
Take this. I'm gonna try to take down this minion who's doing the damage, and take his cloak. And now we should capitalize on this. I am going to go. We don't have enough for a turn. We have 12 with Rainer. But we should be capitalizing on the enemy team's death. So I'm gonna go up to the top lane, try to push this in. Pick up the globe. Get all the gems that I have that I can, and just try to push it in. Again, push in with. There. I'm gonna throw this down there so it deals damage to the structures as well as the minions. And now please put that in. Put another one down. Of course, when the enemy Nova does spawn, I have to be really super careful. I'm super dead, boys! I overextended because I tried to capitalize on the enemy's death. And it looks like our friendly team was just doing completely nothing. Like, they weren't even doing the boss. Like, nobody pinged for boss, so I wasn't doing it. Rainer was just in the middle lane clearing up minion waves. Lunata was just wandering around in the fucking, in our base. And our, looks like our Nova's in trouble. Nova's dead. Yep, we're dead, boys. We're super dead. Actually, their Rainer might be dead. No, he has a healing. But he's gonna be actually killed by the Leaf. Actually, that was huge. That was a huge trade. So now we just push in, right? Oh my god, Rainer gets taken out from that snipe damage. Looks like the enemy Nova actually has her gathering stacks super high. Super high. Why is this game so long? I have to play Gazlowe, and I have to play Gazlowe for 34 minutes now. Oh my god, why did you interrupt her? Like, why? You would have been able to secure a kill, and there's a kill, but triple tap is gonna secure a kill. No, it's not gonna secure a kill, it's actually gonna do nothing, because I think her gathering stacks are actually pretty low. Oh yes, because she died, so her gathering stacks were reset. Now we have to defend, now we have to def as much as we possibly can. Looks like the bottom lane is fine, so I'm gonna go top to deal with this. I'm gonna move away, put down the turret, and just start turning my laser. Of course, this is gonna deal some damage, so I can use it from time to time. You know, it's not the best use of your time, because you know you do have to charge it up. I'm gonna pick up these gems, put down another bomb. Should be able to secure the death of that spider. Slug is in a little trouble here. Enemy Nova trying to do some work there. Put down the bomb, put down this, and you start pumping shit down to that. This Nova Lunara potentially in a very bad position, caught out there. But the enemy Lunara actually caught in an even worse position. Our Lunara is gonna go down, but their Lunara is not gonna go down. I need to be careful, I need to be super careful. I'm gonna put down some turrets. And I'm gonna go make my way down to the Sippy Cup. Got that. Yeah, it is 35 minutes long and I can't see the end of the game. I cannot see a fucking end of the game. What is going on, man? The enemy team tries to push into here, and it looks like they're not successful in doing so. Our Nova does die from the... I have to be careful. I don't want to die. If me and Rainer die here, we might be in a lot of trouble here. I have to be cautious and just get behind cover as soon as the triple tap goes out from the enemy Nova. I'm on my way to try to turn in. Of course they have a vision of that because our team did not... They are scouting as well, and yes, they're definitely doing it. This should be able to secure my escape. I'm just getting the fuck out of here, boys. What is this shit? What is going on? I don't even know what happened. I think they used both blink and I actually didn't do any damage. I'm doing so much siege damage, it's crazy.
I'm going.
I've been recording for 40 minutes, for like 44 minutes now. What the fuck? Okay. So it looks like an enemy Nova is somewhere in this area. So they might be actually doing the boss right here. So we have to be careful. I think the main thing... That's the real Nova! That's the real Nova! We do pick up a kill on the enemy Nova, but looks like our friend Nova does go down in the process as well. I'm actually in the area, I didn't actually see what the hell is going on. They do pick up the boss, and this is a bad boy. This is really bad. I'm just gonna put this in his way so, you know, my shit deals the damage. He is going to stop right in front of the force, so I'm gonna put this bomb and start. There we go. This indeed is one of the longest games I've played. I think this is even longer than the freaking than the Nova game that I played. This one's super long. Anything was trying to push into these towers, so they are successful because they're very, very low on the towers. Any web weavers also defending. We do have to defend. Web weavers are descending, and we have to we have to defend again. What the hell is going on? This is crazy. I have 20 gems on me. This is not safe at all. I'm gonna take this down real quick, and we're gonna move down to the middle lane to just deal with that as soon as we possibly can. I put down those turrets there, didn't collect them because they have to deal with the capitals that are going in the top lane. That's the only reason why I didn't collect them. I'm gonna pick up the scrap metal to get some of my cooldowns back. Looks like the enemy team is pushing right here, so I'm gonna try to. The Dragon Bomb is gonna secure three people in the area, but I think I'll be taken out. Actually, I won't be taken out. I'm gonna just move out of the. I can't help it, I'm sorry. And actually, three members of our friendly team are gonna be taken out. I'm gonna put down the Dragon Bomb. Oh, come on, secure. Yes, our friendly Avatar does so much damage for us, but we are taken out in the process. The enemy Lunara does get taken out as well by our turrets. But I think this is gonna be a good game, actually, boys. Abathur cannot hold this against three people. Yeah, so this is a good game. So hopefully I showed you guys how bad... But not really bad, but how dependable you are on your team when you're Gazlowe. They have to play around you being a split pusher. And they did try to clamp around me, and that's why I was focused by the enemy team a lot in this game. We did some crazy siege damage, right? Must have been like crazy. So much XP as well. This is ridiculous. We do get to level 7 finally on Gazlo. 441 siege damage. That is crazy. That is crazy. Sivanas was getting kind of close. Not really. JK. Right, let's go over the build again. The build is kind of standard now, and everybody knows it. So on level 1, you can go for Scrap-O-Matic. This is going to also allow you to restore mana upon picking up the scrap metal. Level 4, you pick up the Clockwork Steam Fist, but some people also go for Reduce, Reuse, Recycle. This, I have actually explained this on the beginning of the game before I started playing, is that this also allows your enemies, minions, mercenaries, and structures to drop scrap when they die around you. They have a 15% of chance of doing that. Of course, that's pretty nice. That allows you just to get some more cooldowns, more CDR, and more mana with your level 1 talent. But I picked up Clockwork Steam Fists because I wanted to punch things and extend the duration of my turrets. I didn't want to put them down at all. Maybe actually this will reduce reuse and the recycle is actually better. On level 7 I picked up Rocket Turret XL, which allows the turrets to attack up to 2 additional targets, but only for 50% of the damage. But still, it's quite a significant damage. Level 10 I picked up the Grava Bomb, which pulls enemies, and 13 I picked up the Turret Storage, but you can also go for Sprint. Actually definitely Sprint would have been able to secure some of my escapes in the mid game and in the late game, but I went for Turret Storage just to get some more turrets on the map. On 16 I went for the Long Range Turrets, of course that will increase the attack range of turrets, and at the end I went for Miniature Black Hole. This is going to increase the radius by 25% and damage increase by 50, so it's quite a nice damage boost, and also it's going to pull people from farther away. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to leave that like rating. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, that was a long ass freaking game. I hate games like that, which are just like dragging on forever. But anyway, guys, I'm not gonna bore you anymore. And next up, we are playing Avatar, so be prepared for that as one of my master skins. But yeah, again, hope you guys enjoyed. And again, I'll see you guys next time. Peace on the motherfucking streets. Bye.